having a month to prepare for the bowl game. We told ourselves that the end of the season was unacceptable, and that wasn't Tennessee defense. That wasn't our style of play, and we did everything possible to correct that and show what we really were about today, and we came out and did that. I think we held them to, 60-something rushing yards?
Congratulations, okay.
Appreciate it, Coach. And that's what we're about. That's how we started the season, and we just kind of wanted to put our imprint and thumbprint on the end of this season.
Yeah, really like LaTroy and Coach Jones been stressing this whole bowl preparation, getting back to our standard, our style of play, how we play on defense, the fist up, first up, you know, big hits, you know, swarming to the football. That's all we was trying to do, is just get back to that, and I feel like it showed, you know, in our performance.
Did your confidence ever waver late in the year when you were giving up a lot of points and yards?
I mean, obviously when stuff like happens during the end of the year due to injuries and, you know, people not fitting their gaps and just not playing how we're supposed to play, obviously, you know, you're going to get a little down. But the seniors and the leaders came up, stepped up. You know, they galvanized everybody, and we just came back full force during this game.
LaTroy, you got there first, and Corey, you got there before Derek. Yeah, he's searching for that one. You know, watch him get so close so many times and then finally get there. And everybody rushed to Billy, Justin Martin.
It was like a have you ever seen one of those movies where you know it's going to happen and just keep building and building? It just doesn't happen the first time, doesn't happen the second time, does it? It was one of those type of movies where at the end when it finally happened, our entire sideline exploded. And I'm looking over to Coach Jones. I'm like, man, you got to call a timeout or do something because I don't know if everybody's going to stay on the sideline. It was exciting. I wanted that more than anything for Derek. I think as a defensive line, I mean, me, Corey, and Derek text all the time over break when we went home while we were in Knoxville. You know, we were talking about how this is the best the three of us had played and the D-line as a group, period. We felt that was the best we had been practicing and playing since fall camp. And we're excited. We're excited for Derek to get the sack. And I'm proud of him. He can officially call himself the greatest of all time.
Jay, what's it like to block for Josh when he's scrambling like that and getting open yards? Is it one of those things where you block and then you kind of try and figure out where he is?
Well, is this work? Okay. Well, Dobbs, you know, he's a guy who can definitely extend plays. Dobbs is definitely a guy who has the potential to extend plays at any time during the game. So, honestly, you kind of have a body clock. You're blocking, you know, let's say 3 or 4 seconds. You kind of have a body clock knowing when the ball should be gone. And when the ball isn't gone, you know he's back there extending plays and making things happen. So he's a guy that you have to continuously strain for. That's a lot of guys in our program who not only Dobbs, but our running backs, our receivers, those guys are always fighting for extra yardage and those type of things, so you can never just let up.
Was tonight kind of an all-encompassing performance for him? You had the deep ball to Malone, all the runs, some nice balls. Was this kind of just – this summed up tonight who kind of Josh Dobbs has become as the quarterback?
For sure. I definitely agree with exactly what you said. Dobbs has been a guy who could hurt you with his feet, with his arm, all those sorts of things. And when you have somebody like that in the backfield, it definitely helps as an offensive lineman. It's a little bit unpredictable for us at times, but it's unpredictable for them too. But like you said, he's made a lot of plays throughout his career and made a lot of plays today.
LaTroy, Corey, both you guys, when did you realize Derek was a little bit different, you know, or was as good of a player as he was? You remember the first maybe practices or first time you're around him that, you know, that he had a little different mentality than the typical freshman, was a different player?
Definitely for me, when I noticed that he was going to separate from everybody or had the ability to, was the first day in pads. First day I saw him in pads, because, you know, the first couple of days of camp is gym class. We run around jerseys. He ran well. That was fine. We had a lot of people run well. But when we put on the pads, it's the demeanor he brings and the attitude he brings to the game, everything. He wanted to be great at everything he did, not just as a pass rusher, but as a run stopper. When he had to drop in coverage, he wanted to be great at that too. And just his attitude towards everything, the physicality he played with, and attention to detail. I mean, even this year, not even saying just his freshman, even this year, times that he's come to me or come to Corey and like, hey, what do you think about this? Or how can I do this better? And just his will to continuously get better. I do not think this is the peak for Derek Barnett at all.
The first day he came in, you know, he's like, yeah, man, we're trying to make sure, you know, we bring this program back and stuff. For me, it wasn't when we got in pads. It was when we was running, this little laps around the field and stuff, and he was burning everybody. And, like, and he was keeping up with the DBs in their group. That's when I knew. I said, okay, something special about this kid. Because you don't see a lot of people doing that. Last dude I saw doing that was A.J. Johnson. Y'all know about him, so.
Can you guys talk about the bowl prep, the tackling, and how much did that help for you defenders to get an opportunity to hit in practice? I know that during the course of the season there were so many injuries, and maybe even the preseason there wasn't a lot. What is your thoughts about more contact practices for Tennessee?
Physicality. At the end of the day, a lot of the time, well, football period at the end of the day is a physical game, and especially when we get to bowl games. Some teams drop off in physicality and technique and tackling, and that's one of the things we really drove home and emphasized. Our coaches made sure we knew what the downfall of bowl games usually are, and we said we won't be that team. We won't be one of those teams. And we wanted to have a hard edge when it came to our physical play and toughness, and, you know, being in pads, more this bowl prep than the last couple definitely helped us do that, and it shows in the way we stopped the run and things we're able to do.
When you were asked what's the legacy of this team 120, what would you say it is after the bowl win?
I guess I would say personally resiliency. If you could pick one word, if I could pick one word to describe team 120, it'd be resiliency. Through the injuries that we've battled all year and some tough losses, some big wins last second, we never wavered. And mentally, for most teams, it would be an up and a down and up and a down. And I can honestly say that we had a group of guys that stuck with each other and really, really came together as a family down the stretch.
Last question.
What do you tell the underclassmen and the players coming in? What do you tell them as far as playing for Coach Jones, playing for the University of Tennessee?
Shoot, what I would tell him is, no matter what happens, no matter what the scoreboard look like, put work in. Work hard. Every dude I've seen successful come out of here has worked hard, and, you know, they've already had natural talents. But working hard and being smart, studying your craft, and, like, really getting better relentlessly, it can't go wrong. That's what I would tell him.
I would tell him, you are the T, and the T is you. At the end of the day, you're only as good as your past and your history. So for every defensive end that comes through here, for the rest of time is, you know, Derek Barnett is the standard of what Tennessee football is, or whoever it may be, Josh Dobbs is the standard for what a Tennessee quarterback is, and just really owning what it means to be a volunteer and wear a power T on your chest.